Is the job market really this bad? Can you share some advice to find a job in tech in 2023 or 2024? What's going on with the job market? Job market improving at all? Can't find a job after 6 months of being laid off. Should I apply for junior positions instead? This is nothing new. If you're looking for a job in tech, as a software engineer, we know it's hard to find. I'm a data analyst and I spent a long time researching the 2024 tech job market. And if you stick around, I am going to bring the receipts to show you how bad the job market really is and if jobs are really going to come back. Just to give you an idea of how bad it is, in 2008, during the recession, 65,000 tech jobs were laid off, and everyone thought that was a big thing. But in 2022, 165,000 jobs were laid off. And if you think that's bad, in 2023, 263,000 jobs have been laid off. That's a 59% increase from 2022. Why did this happen? Well, we know in 2022, there was an economic downturn. We had a pandemic, a war, high interest rates, high inflation rates. So what this means is that people just stop spending. And if people stop spending, businesses stop spending. And generally that means that the tech companies that rely on businesses to buy advertising space or to even buy their platforms, well, they don't do too well, which essentially caused the layoffs. Now, is 2024 just as bad as 2023? Well, to be honest, it's not looking great according to my research. We're already on 42,000 jobs lost in tech as of March 2024. Not as bad as last year, but still substantial. There's still big companies that are laying off people in 2024. We have Apple, Amazon, Dell, Sony, Expedia, Microsoft, PayPal. All of these companies have had layoffs in 2024 within the first 3 or 4 months. Now, it does seem like layoffs in general seem to be the highest at the beginning of the year and then slow down as the year continues. So hopefully that's a trend, and hopefully that means that there won't be any major layoffs. But why is this important? Well, we know if layoffs are still coming, then it just answers the question of supply and demand. Unfortunately, the amount of employers in tech just massively outweighs the amount of demand in tech, which means people lose their jobs. And it does look like this issue is still happening in 2024. Now, in terms of the layoffs in 2024, is it the same reasons as the layoffs in 2023? And yes, we do have a lot of companies who have specifically said that they are laying off employees because of the economic downturn and they simply just can't afford it. But there also have been mentions of companies using AI to replace people and their jobs. So IBM is reportedly slashing its marketing and communications team. The company has previously announced a strategy to actually replace up to 8,000 jobs with AI. Turnitin also laid off some people this year following the comments from the CEO named Chris Caron that the company would be able to actually reduce its headcount by 20%, again, thanks to AI. Duolingo also confirmed it cut about 10% of its contract staff at the end of 2023. As it turns out, AI can actually stream that content production and translations as well, which were previously handled by humans. Grammarly is also laying off about 230 employees worldwide. Again, they want to focus on an AI-enabled workplace. Now, these are just some companies who have stated that AI might replace some jobs. In my opinion, I don't think that there are a lot of companies who would actually publicly state that they are using AI instead of people, just because it just doesn't look good. I mean, I'm reading some of these statements and it just seems cruel. There are about 267 companies that have laid off tech jobs this year. And obviously, just a small amount of companies have said it was because of AI. I think there's probably more in that number who have laid off people because they want AI to replace those jobs. But obviously, they may not want to say because it just doesn't sound good. It's a great time to be alive. So layoffs aren't looking good. Fine. What about hiring? Are companies still hiring? So looking at the unemployment rate for the US, It indicates that the change is very little, meaning there's no mass layoffs across all industries. But we do know that there have been a bunch of layoffs in the tech industry recently. So is the job market for tech specifically just bad? Well, according to Indeed.com, job postings are actually back to pre-pandemic levels, which means levels before 2020. And 39 of the 47 industries tracked by Indeed, 39 of them had job postings back at the same level as they were before the pandemic. But they did say 37 out of the 49, which leads the question, well, which industries are actually shrinking? And you guessed it, it is tech-related job postings. So tech-related job postings in sectors including software development, IT operations, and information design and documentation have actually fallen drastically from their peak, which you can see over here. That means that there is a sharp decline in the amount of job postings available. Good old software development is right on top with a minus 28% change since February 1st, 2020, followed by information design, mathematics, marketing, and then media and communications. Interesting though, that list there does look like industries that can be taken over by AI. Now, if you're looking for industries which had an increase in job postings, these are sectors that have the largest increase: physicians and surgeons, therapy, civil engineering, personal care and home health, and pharmacy. If you're willing to maybe study an extra 10 years to become a physician or a surgeon, it could help you get hired. And again, I have to note that these fields are probably quite difficult for AI to break into. We know that the medical field, there's a whole lot of ethics there. Therapy, again, ethics. Civil engineering, you know, you can probably do mechanized machinery. I'm a chemical engineer, but again, it is quite hard. Personal care and home health, pharmacy, I think it is quite hard for AI to break through and steal those jobs, especially entry-level jobs. So layoffs aren't great. Hiring doesn't look great, based on the decrease in job postings. Are there any tech jobs in demand? According to Wall Street Journal, AI talent is in demand. That makes sense based on the information that we've seen. And it does look like postings for AI-related job roles are on the increase. So if you don't want to become a physician, a surgeon, or civil engineer, if you still want to stay in tech, could be worth looking at a specialization in AI in the field that you're interested in. So it does look like the AI jobs are up 42% compared with December 22, which was a low point. And obviously this is in line with the release of ChatGPT, which obviously caused this AI chaos. But if AI is not your thing and you're sick of it, like most people, Indeed also noted something interesting. Remote job postings are actually declining, and it does seem like companies want people back into the office. As of Feb 16, postings that are not 100% remote were up 27% from their pre-pandemic levels. So it does seem like working from home is less popular. If you have been searching jobs with the remote filter on, consider removing that and look for jobs closer to home. You might have more success. And now I guess you have to ask a question, how do you get a job in 2024? So the old stat that goes around is that 85% of jobs are filled through networking. Now personally, that stat does seem a bit wrong and inflated. There's definitely no source there, but I do believe that networking might be your best chance. And this is based on me looking at the data. So the average number of applicants per job or per hire is 278, meaning that a recruiter would need to screen 100 plus candidates just for one job role. And that makes sense based on my own personal experience, because if I go to LinkedIn and if I search software engineer on LinkedIn and just pull up the first job that I come across, this job here has 300 applicants in the last day, and the next job exactly similar stats, 297 applicants within the past day. Now, I can't imagine recruiters actually sifting through 100 plus candidates just for one role. It's a lot of work and it's a lot of to go through. And I think if a good developer from their company is recommending someone, that makes a big difference. So try networking, attend events, post on social media, make friends in a similar industry and see if that works. I can tell you that having conversations with managers about their product and their business makes a big difference as opposed to just randomly going and asking for a job, especially now when you are competing against hundreds of applicants. That being said, it is still a hard time to find a job. Will the market pick up anytime soon? It doesn't look like, based on this information, hopefully that changes, but it just means that you would need to change your game plan if you are looking for a job. Hope this helps. Sources are all below. If you like my videos, please like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.